is up, everybody? It's Kimberly. Welcome back to my channel, and I want to introduce you to my friend Valeria.
Hello.
She is from the channel Valeria Lipovetsky here on YouTube, and today we are collaborating
about a very, very important subject. How to look good
in every picture.
She played a fiddle in an Irish band, but she fell in love with an Englishman.
Kissed her on the neck and then I took her by the hands. Baby, I just wanna dance. One of the biggest questions that we have here on this channel is about how to curate your social media profiles, like how to look hot and like your best in every single photo. And Valeria is actually a model. She does this like for a living, and she has amazing tips on how like you can get your body to look its very best in every photo, and like just kind of like how to make your feed look stunning, amazing.
Yeah, I just feel like even for either to create a good feed and obviously also show, you know, the guy or girl of your interest, like I am the shit. Mm-hmm. It's also good for you, for your confidence. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
When you know your angles, when you see your photos looking good, you're like, you know what? I got this.
You're like, damn, I'm hot. And it just gives you that much more confidence in real life.
Exactly.
Which is, you know, with the whole point of everything.
And you know what? The secret is not to be born beautiful without any flaws. The secret is to do a little research, a little bit of practice, and you're good to go.
Exactly. So if you guys do all six of these things, you are going to be social media ready. And we definitely want to see your interpretation on social media. So definitely DM us or send us pictures
tag
on
us.
Instagram and Twitter, because we want to see like how these tips work for you. So we are actually doing a huge giveaway with this video for
the Tarte Lipstick Rainforest of the Sea.
Woo! So guys, you're gonna get 24 of the most gorgeous lipsticks. We had one of these in my 500k giveaway that hasn't been announced yet, but guys, you guys all went bananas, and so I feel like whoever wins this is just never gonna need lipstick ever again.
Yes.
You're gonna look good in every picture.
Every picture, yeah. This is amazing. They're all like marble.
Yeah, they're so, I feel like this would look so good, not just on your lips, but you could put these in like
for Instagram. For your Instagram feed. Multi-purpose.
So pretty. So in order to enter, you guys, all you have to do is be subscribed to both of our channels here on YouTube and follow us both on Instagram and leave us a comment of some kind, like about the giveaway, or it could be-
Let us remember you.
Exactly.
If we remember you, you are, you know, your chances are higher. So.
Exactly. We want to see like who comes up with the most creative comment or interpretation of our video.
Yes.
So good luck to everyone, and we will leave all of the information down below in case you forget. All right.
Let's get back to work.
Yes.
How to look good in every picture.
Oh my gosh. I need help, Valeria. Help me. I feel like everyone's gonna love this so much. Can you just put that on the ground? Thank you. It's so heavy. It's like, it's just go everywhere.
Okay, so our first tip is inspiration.
Yes. So finding your inspiration, like when I first started doing Instagram, I found this really tough because I was like, do I just like stand in front of a brick wall? Like, what do I do, right? So your tip is like about like start by collecting some images that you like.
Yeah, and you know what? Like today we have so many platforms that we can use. I love Pinterest for that.
Yeah.
I love Instagram. I save them on my feed, on my Instagram account, and you have the functionality. Like Instagram thought about this. They're like, how do we get girls to have good photos?
Yeah.
Let them save inspo photos. So I always make sure that I have a bunch of things that I like beautiful girls, beautiful scenery, anything that will inspire you, your mood. It helps in life.
Yeah.
Like a mood board.
It's like a mood board. Like when you go to a modeling shoot and you go in and there's a mood board there. So then when you see something like that in real life, because like for me, I'm really big on colors. Like I love blues and pinks. And if you guys see my feed, you'll notice like it's really pastel-y and colorful.
Yeah, bright, happy.
Yeah. So when I come into contact, like if I'm eating an ice cream cone and they're just happens to be like a nice beautiful blue setting, I'm like, oh, this would be perfect because it looks like my inspiration photos.
Exactly. And you know what else? You'll find like to create a good feed, you'll find that the photos that you save on your camera, there's gonna be like a common, you know, thing to it. And you'll slowly realize, like you'll figure out what your style, and that kind of contribute to an overall strong Instagram game.
Exactly.
So inspiration is everywhere. You go and find it.
Exactly. Yeah, your Instagram feed says something about you, right? Like when someone looks at that, they're getting a snapshot of kind of like who you are.
And for more kind of getting, you know, to the basics of actually posing, there's so many beautiful girls on social media that figured out how to look good in photos.
Mm-hmm.
So what I do, I started seeing like a pose that everyone repeats, like, you know, first to put a leg in the front, or just like all these different things that we're gonna show you that you can do. And I started noticing it happening in all these Instagrams. So I was like, maybe I should try it.
That's so
smart. And voila, it worked.
Exactly.
So the second tip that I would recommend, and that's something that I've learned before social media, it was in modeling. I had the pleasure to work with a lot of experts that just know what to do. And I've noticed that even observing models, you get to know your body, you get to know what works for your body. If you want to showcase a certain part, there's a way of posing. Like for me, I always want to make sure that I look tall. So
yeah, me too.
Yeah, it's always, you always want to look like an Amazon. Yeah,
exactly.
Amazon woman. So, you know, I've noticed that putting one leg forward, like a fake step, always works. And you find it on all these like IG models. Mm-hmm. They all do
like
it.
Like the one leg. And I've noticed that in a lot of your pictures, Valeria, how like you'll be kind of putting one leg forward and then leaning back a little bit to kind of create that really long illusion. And we're going to do some of that in the B-roll today.
Like, yes.
To show you guys how to do that.
Yeah. And it's always, I mean, at the end of the day, we're all looking for, you know, to enhance the curves that we like.
Yeah.
And to not hide, but just like blur a little bit the things that don't necessarily look
Absolutely.
Good in photos.
It's all about the silhouette too. Like for me as a short girl, I find that when I have my arms pressed up against my body like this, it can create the illusion of like thicker arms. But when you kind of elongate your arm or elongate your leg, that can create like a nicer silhouette as well.
And it might like feel weird for you while you're doing that pose. You're like, this looks so unnatural, but you'll be surprised how natural it looks.
Exactly.
Another like thing that I love doing is like, oh, you took a picture, I didn't notice. You are in your own little world, in your own little bubble. Don't have to, you know, necessarily stare at the photographer, at the lens. You can laugh, you can twirl around.
The other thing for body lines is, Valeria always says, like, separate your legs in photos. So, like, if you're wearing mom jeans or wearing, like, pants that create, like, a crotch line.
No one wants to see that, trust me.
So, yeah, I recently started doing this and I actually really liked it. Like, standing with your legs kind of, like, apart can actually create, like, a really nice silhouette as well.
Yeah, it looks good. Clothes look better. Mm-hmm. You look tall. You look cleaner. Separate your legs in photos.
Try it. You won't regret it.
So the next tip is like being candid. I find that a lot of girls sometimes, especially when they just start with, you know, social media, just taking photos, they feel like they need to be this like very
serious, looking right at the camera, like professional.
Yeah,
model.
We're not looking for like haute couture type. Is that how you say it?
Haute couture?
You say haute couture?
I say haute couture. What do you say? Haute couture?
French,
I say
right?
Hot.
None of us
That's
speak
like very
it,
American
so.
Haute couture.
You don't want to look like hot couture. You don't want to look like you're trying too hard. You know what I mean? Today, on social media especially, we have the opportunity to show like happiness and life and your personality. And you know, you can just, you can pretend like it's a paparazzi. You don't have
Absolutely.
To look at the photo. Right?
Absolutely. And one of the big things as well, you guys, is that we've talked on this channel about it before. When you actually have friends in your Instagram photos, that's a great way of showing that you are, you know, you're not just a narcissistic person who takes only photos of yourself. So you can even create candid moments with friends where you guys are all like laughing together or having fun in a photo. And that really creates like a strong impression to like the guy or girl that you like, that you are like a person like with their own thing going on, who has like their own social circle and who's like cool, to hang around with.
I mean, my Instagram is mostly me, so.
Yeah, but you're, you know, I think it's different when like a public profile and
this is
what you do for a living.
But
you know, like if you guys are watching and you know, you want to impress your crush on social media,
it's
and like
true.
You have friends, I think it's important to like include them in your photos and show people like a little inside scoop into your life. You
and
know?
It's interesting. People wonder, they're like, what are they doing? They're having such fun.
Exactly. Give them a little bit of FOMO. Wish they make your crush wish they were hanging out with you.
Yes.
Friend.
Yes, definitely. So be candid, be, you know, take advantage of the fact that it's not a photo shoot, it's not serious. You can create the mood that you want and have fun with it.
Yeah, exactly. Like when I first started doing Instagram, I would always just look right at the camera and I'd be like, as if it was like some portrait. And then I realized, oh yeah, like it doesn't have to be so serious. Like I can just look away and that actually looks really natural. And
I love those photos of you. It looks like, you know, a ray of sunshine. You're just like, you're having fun, you're twirling, like the colors, everything. It's just, it really brings, you know, a certain feeling to a person that looks at these photos. So
exactly.
Embrace it.
Yep, just do it. Get candid, have fun. And if someone walks by and sees you doing a candid photo, don't be embarrassed, because everyone knows that we do it for the gram, right?
I feel like people already are not that surprised when they see like girls just like, ha, 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 ha. Did you get it? Did you get it? Okay, enough
this
for them.
Happens all the time.
Always. Oh my god. I like even with my husband sometimes just like, Gary, take a photo. Okay, done, let's go.
Like you think we're joking, but we're really not. Like this happens. And don't be afraid and don't be embarrassed if it happens to you, because you'll have a freaking amazing feed and that's what matters. Okay, number four, you guys, is find your lighting. And Valeria is like an expert on lighting, and she knows, like, you say that natural light is the best light.
Natural light is totally the best. You chase that light wherever you need to go, you go there. I honestly believe that it doesn't matter, you're not wearing any makeup, you look like, you know, like a mess. If you stand in front of a window with natural light, you're gonna look like the Sleeping Beauty.
Goddess.
Right?
Yeah.
Maybe not the Sleeping Beauty, that's weird. The goddess, you're gonna look amazing.
Like a goddess.
It just, it makes, you know, it does this like blurs everything. Mm-hmm. I don't know what it is, it's weird.
And if you go in the direct sunlight, you're gonna get like shadows on your
yes,
face.
Yes, no.
So like ideally you're taking photos outside on like an overcast day or actually from in the yes. shade, right?
Overcast is always the best. And I actually like when we, even when we're doing things for like my social media, when it's sunny days, like I stay away. Mm-hmm. I make sure it's overcast, it gives a good mood to the photo, it does amazing lighting, and yeah. That's the way to go. But lighting is everything.
Yes. But what do you do like if you're in a place where it's dark? Like if you're in a club or like at a party or something, like how would you still get that perfect image, like finding your light?
Ring light, girl.
Yeah.
Ring light. They come in all shapes, sizes, colors. You can find it anywhere.
We're using a ring light right now.
Yes.
It's like a big one.
And this is a big one, but I actually have one in my video. I showed like I have like a little one that just attaches to your phone. It's like this size and it's
mm-hmm.
I got some mm-hmm. real good selfies.
Oh, I need to get one. I need to get one.
Yes.
And we'll share a little bit of what we take on that too.
Yes. Number five is really having like different moods.
Yes.
And you know, emotion. You do it really well.
Rihanna!
I love on your Instagram, you have like have different emotions.
Thank you. So I try.
Yeah. I find that that's such a great tip to, you know, take advantage of that good photo. Because if you're already making someone to take your photo,
yes.
You know it's going to be a good picture. So like take advantage of it and yeah, play around with expression.
On your feed, I noticed Valeria has like a few kind of like key emotions that yes. she uses that look really good. So one of them is like a thinking face.
This is like a classic IG model thinking yes. face when they're like doing something like this. Like
yeah.
Something with a finger in their mouth. I don't know what it is. I don't do it, but that's a really good go-to. And yeah. I find that it also, it's like a trick to make your lips look bigger.
Oh.
Fun fact.
That's a fun fact. I've yes. never heard that before.
Yeah. I always play around. And like I make, you know, if someone takes pictures, no one takes today one frame. Like,
exactly.
If your friends are real friends, they know to take more than one picture. So they're gonna keep clicking, and I think the secret is to really like, you know, give different expressions so you can choose from. So yeah. my go-to expressions are like, you know, when I'm being just like cute, and then when I'm laughing hysterically, probably like a little cuter than what I just did. One when, you know, someone's calling me. What would be your go-to?
I probably do like cute. See, like hold the hair and like look up like, ooh.
Yeah.
Like that kind of look. Like yeah. really like Betty Boop kind of look.
Exactly. So it's like you're moving with them, and then once you move with the expressions, and then once you have the photos, you'll be like, I have all this variety to choose from.
Exactly.
What do I feel like today?
Exactly.
Right?
You can go, yeah. And you can choose like the emotion that works the best on your own feed that you yeah. think is kind of going to fit the mood for that day.
And you can be moody, you can look away, you can be happy, you can be upset, you can be like, what? I have a photo that did so well on my Instagram. It was in New York, and I'm literally like, and it was mid-action. I was completely like calling someone out for something, but it's like it was such a good photo. So, you know, it shows your personality.
Yeah.
So keep it fun.
Exactly.
And that's kind of moving us to the last tip.
Yes. Point number six, and I used to do this all the time. Mm-hmm. Like, it's a tip to avoid. So like when you ask someone to take your picture, a lot of times they're gonna take like a whole bunch of photos. And if they don't, I feel like they're not, you know, a very good-
They're not real friends.
It's just like a stranger walking down the street. Like most people know to take like at least a few good photos.
Yeah.
And so use that to your advantage. Don't just stand there in the exact same pose the whole time like I used to do. Like you can actually move around with it. Like try the emotions that we just talked mm-hmm. about, but then also like move your face and try some different angles. So when you actually choose your photo, like you're able to choose the one that's like most flattering to you.
So a good thing with angles, that's something that takes a little bit of practice, but honestly so worth it because mm-hmm. once you master it, you are good to go. So I always recommend for girls to sit in front of the mirror. You already putting your makeup and making yourself extra pretty. So like take 2 to 5 more minutes of just standing there and seeing what works for your face. So move it, you know, tilt your head, find your favorite side. So when there's gonna be a picture opportunity, you're not gonna be like,
yes.
you're just gonna be like,
you'll be confident. You'll look like for anything in life, practice makes perfect. And selfies and photos are no different. So like the more you get used to it and the more you just get over it and realize that practice is everything, you'll be amazing.
Exactly. Those are the tips.
Yes.
Do you feel like you learned a lot?
I feel like I learned so much and I'm so excited to go out there and try
we're gonna put this to practice now.
Yes. I just wanna say thank you so much, Valeria, for coming on my channel. Like that was so much fun. I feel like we learned so much and you guys have to like keep us posted on how these tips work for you.
Yes, tag us. We wanna see your Instagram worthy images.
Yes, and guys, we also did a collab over on Valeria's channel where we're talking all about how to tell if your crush likes you, which is something I know you guys are definitely interested in. And we're hearing some of Valeria's personal experiences as well, and she's just hilarious.
And I had some questions. So you were good, you answered it.
Thank you. So head on over to her channel and make sure that you enter the giveaway by subscribing to both of us here on YouTube and following us both on Instagram and leaving a comment over on our Instagrams because we can't wait to hear from you guys.
Yes. Thank you so much for having me.
All right. Thank you for coming on and we'll see you guys next week for another video on relationships.
Bye. Bye guys.